Oracle continues to deliver a superior ownership experience by offering pre-built virtual machines of PeopleSoft HCM 9.2, ELM 9.2, and FSCM 9.2 for VirtualBox, with CRM 9.2 coming soon. These virtual machines enable you to have ready-made application environments for upgrade, maintenance, and demonstrations. You no longer have to invest time and effort in installing environments for demonstrations. This video discusses the PeopleSoft VirtualBox images for patching, demonstration, and upgrade. We also have production-class Oracle virtual machine templates for the PeopleTools middle tier that you can review on My Oracle Support. Oracle VM VirtualBox is a virtual single-user virtualization product for enterprise and home use. VirtualBox is machine-bound, so it does not require multiple servers in order to deploy a virtualization solution. There's no management overhead because it can be run on a single workstation. It doesn't require system administrators for installation or management since you can simply download the virtual machine from My Oracle Support and begin using it on your own standalone system. A virtual machine is usually host-bound, running on a single machine, which can even be a laptop system. On that system, you have regular applications, such as an email client, a browser, and whatever software tools you use to perform your work. Then, the VirtualBox hypervisor is loaded, which communicates with both the physical resources on the machine and the guest operating system. So, when a guest operating system is running, the instructions that would normally go to the network, the disk, and the processor go through the hypervisor. Before you start using the PeopleSoft virtual appliances, you need the following: a 64-bit machine. The CPU must be able to address 64-bit memory and a 64-bit host OS. Currently, we support Windows 7 or higher. You'll need up to 6 gigabytes of available memory, and perhaps more as our virtual images change over time. You need to make sure that you have switched on the CPU virtualization extensions in the BIOS of your host computer, and you have VirtualBox 4.x installed. The host machine used for the demonstration you see in this video has a dual-core CPU, 50 gigabytes of free disk space on the host hard drive, and 8 gigabytes of RAM. For the demonstration in this video, the Oracle Linux appliance requires 2 virtual CPUs, 30 gigabytes of disk space, and 6 gigabytes of virtual RAM, all of which can run easily on the host machine we're using. Within the virtual appliance, we have a web server, an application server, a process scheduler, a PeopleTools demonstration database, and secure enterprise search. There are 3 VirtualBox appliance types available from Oracle PeopleSoft. The PeopleSoft patching image is only for maintenance of your system and contains a repository of fixes. A new image is available several times per year on a consistent regular schedule. You can check the My Oracle Support article listed on screen for more information. The demo image is designed to help you with problem resolution and feature assessment. These images contain a full application database and file system on the current PeopleTools patch level. Oracle Secure Enterprise Search is included as well. Once you've downloaded and started your PeopleSoft demo image VirtualBox virtual machine, you can log in and use the application for demonstrations and conference room pilots. You can use the PeopleSoft 9.2 upgrade source image as your new release demo database during your upgrade to PeopleSoft 9.2. This image remains static and is not updated until the next certified upgrade source is released. Once you install the PeopleSoft 9.2 upgrade source image, you can continue the upgrade process using the PeopleSoft Change Assistant and the PeopleSoft 9.2 upgrade documentation found on your application's upgrade homepage. You can find all of these appliances on My Oracle Support. They all contain PeopleTools, any required third-party applications, and a runtime environment that lets you log into PIA as soon as you turn on the virtual machine. Before the PeopleSoft virtual appliances were available, you had to complete a number of time-consuming activities in order to set up a demo environment before your users could assess new releases. The first step, after procuring your hardware, was to install the OS, then install the database, PeopleTools, and associated software, then install updates to the database, create the application and web servers, and finally boot the environment and log in. VirtualBox appliances make this process much easier. They work as soon as you switch them on. There's no need to install anything to the virtual machine. Within 30 minutes, you can be logged into PIA and working. The first step is to download the virtual appliances from My Oracle Support. Then, you need to import the appliance into VirtualBox from your file system. Once the appliance is imported successfully, you can boot and customize the virtual machine. Because of the size of virtual appliances, they usually take a number of hours to download, even with a fast connection. Once the templates have been downloaded locally, it will take approximately 10 to 15 minutes to import the appliance from a local disk. The importing process results in the creation of a virtual machine from the virtual appliance. Then, you can start your virtual machine for the first time, This usually takes about 25 minutes and requires an operator at the machine to respond to the prompts during the boot process. This demonstration is only going to walk through the import and initial startup of the virtual machine. After you download a PeopleSoft virtual appliance from My Oracle Support, your next step is to import the virtual appliance into VirtualBox. This file contains the disk images that will be part of the ultimate virtual machine and an OVF file that contains the metadata information about that virtual machine. To import the file, open VirtualBox Manager and go to File, Import Appliance. Then, enter the location of the virtual appliance. Now you can see the appliance import settings for this virtual appliance, which includes the amount of RAM required for the appliance, the number of CPUs, and the disk images for this appliance. Selecting the Reinitialize the MAC address of all network cards prevents any namespace conflicts that could occur as a result of duplicate MAC network addresses on the network adapters. Once you click the Import button, the system begins copying the entire 11.5 GB into a new virtual appliance image. This process takes somewhere between 5 and 15 minutes. Once the import process is completed, you can see a new virtual machine on the left side of the VirtualBox Manager screen. At this point, you're ready to start the virtual machine. Once you click the Start button, you see the virtual machine beginning to initialize. You'll see the Linux operating system initializing. Enter Y for Yes when you see the security warning. The system prompts you to enter a new password for the root user. Make sure you remember this password for later. For our demonstration, we're going to enable dynamic IP configuration. Configure the host name for the system. Review your network configuration. Make a note of the IP address for the appliance. You'll need this later. Once the operating system is configured, the system begins initializing the PeopleSoft components. During the initialization process, there are a lot of components configured for you. You can ignore the process scheduler errors. When the virtual machine is successfully initialized, the system displays the login screen. At this point, you can log into PIA. You'll need to have the IP address used by the VM when it initialized. Then, you can immediately begin working in your PeopleSoft environment. Remember, VirtualBox must be installed onto a physical machine that meets the hardware requirements mentioned earlier. You can't run a virtual machine inside of another virtual machine. You can run many virtual machines on a physical system, but not one inside another. Although the virtual machine must run on a physical machine, the virtual machine storage does not have to be local. The storage for the virtual machine can be connected through a fast external device connection. When a VM is stopped or in a suspended or sleeping state, it doesn't consume any resources on the machine other than the disk storage. Snapshots allow you to return to an earlier stable or safe state when corruption occurs. Think of snapshotting as a simple form of version control. You can take a snapshot at any time in order to save a good state and return to it at a later time. Cloning is a way of taking a virtual machine that you have configured and making that available for use by others. There is no technical expertise required when working with these virtual machines. Your users can start the virtual machine and functionally work with it with only a minimal knowledge of the Linux operating system. For more information about the types of VirtualBox appliances available for PeopleSoft, go to My Oracle Support and find one of the articles listed on this screen.